talking about my summer essentials. So these are my must-have beauty products for summer, and as well as my fashion favorites for summer. And I'm also going to be showing you guys my favorite bathing suits from this season. So I'm really excited about that because I've got some cute ones this year. And let's go ahead and get started. So I'm first going to start off with a couple makeup products that I have here. The first being my Clinique Moisture Surge Tinted Moisturizer, and this has SPF 15 in it. This is a little sample size. They do periodically give out samples at Clinique, so make sure you check your counter if you want to try it out before you actually spend the money on it. I had like two or three of these, so I haven't actually had to buy it yet, but I love this tinted moisturizer. It gives very good coverage, and I just love how it's very lightweight, doesn't smell like sunscreen, and it just goes on perfectly. You can apply it really quickly with your finger. So I actually have a foundation here, and I don't like wearing foundation that much in the summertime, but if I'm going to work, I like to have a little bit more coverage, or I'm going to be out somewhere all day like shopping or something. I do like to have coverage on my skin for that. So the foundation that I've been loving is the CoverGirl Outlast Stay Fabulous 3-in-1 foundation. This is an awesome foundation for the summertime because it gives really good coverage, but it stays on your face all day and it doesn't wear off at all. I can do a full like tutorial review if you guys want to see that on this foundation, but I've been using it for a few months now, about since the time it came out. And mine is in this shade 832, which is nude beige. So it's definitely my summer shade. It says that this is, it has SPF 20 in it, so that's good as well if you're gonna be out in the sun. But it says it has lasting power of a primer, coverage of a concealer, and blendability of foundation in one, and it's shine free. This is definitely a matte foundation, so you could probably even get away with not using a powder unless you're very oily. I like to put this on and let it set, that way I can really see the coverage, let it go ahead and dry, and then go in with my concealer, and I'll just put powder over the areas that I'm using concealer on. But sometimes I don't even need concealer if I'm not having a breakout or anything, so this is just really excellent at coverage and it lasts a really long time. It reminds me a lot of the Revlon color Stay, but I feel like it has even better coverage than that. And then for the powder that I love for the summertime is the NYX Stay Matte But Not Flat Powder Foundation. But I've been using this shade Soft Beige. Perfect if I'm just going to the beach and I want a little bit of powder on my face, just a small bit of coverage and not being too heavy and doesn't like sweat off your face or anything. So I really like this for the coverage, and it also lasts a really long time. And then if you wear it over top of a foundation, it just gives that little bit of added coverage and it makes your foundation last all day. I like it because it doesn't make you look cakey, because it says stay matte but not flat, so it doesn't give you that really flat appearance, but then it doesn't have any shimmer or anything in it. And then I have a mascara top coat. This is actually from Nicole from our swap from last year, but this is the Anastasia Lash Genius. This is a mascara top coat. I've talked about this several times in my summer makeup routine video that I did. It was called Hot Weather Makeup Tutorial, so make sure you check that out because I use a lot of these products in that tutorial. But, and I also mentioned this, I think, in my last summer favorites video last year. But I really like this because I can put it over top any mascara that I have, because I don't like to use waterproof mascara because it's hard to remove. But on a day when I actually want to have a waterproof mascara, then I can just put this over top because it is a clear top coat. And the brush is really nice too, so it doesn't like make your mascara get clumpy, or it doesn't reshape your lashes after you've already done your mascara. But I really like it for when I'm going to the beach, or if I want to prevent my mascara from smudging, I'll just take a little bit of this and dab it on the top of my lashes, just on the tips, because that's sometimes where I can get smudging, like right here or down here, if it's going to be really hot and I'm sweating and stuff with a regular mascara. Okay, now I guess I will talk about skincare products. The first one that I have is my Aveeno Ultra Calming Daily Moisturizer. This is SPF 15. All the products that I use on my face in the summertime have SPF in it because I don't like getting sunburn. You want to keep your face from aging and all that kind of stuff, but even if I'm going to the pool or a beach, I just use this and I don't have to use any other sunscreen on my face. It's only 15, but for some reason it just works really well and I don't get burned at all. I lay down on the beach for probably most of the day. I think I got there around noon and stayed until like 4 or so. So 4 hours out in the direct sunlight on the beach in the hot sun, and I did not get a burn at all on my face. This actually worked better than the 30 sunscreen, like Banana Boat or something, that I used on my chest, because I still got burned on my chest with using a 30. Used this just on my face, never got burnt at all. So this works just amazing at that, and I love this moisturizer. Keeps me from getting too dry, and it's just very nice because it's calming. I talk all about this in my updated skincare routine. It's called How I Cured My Acne, so I will link that video down below if y'all are interested in seeing more about my skincare routine, but I love that moisturizer. And then of course, I cannot make this video without mentioning my Sun Goddess Self Tanner. I use this stuff religiously, probably at least twice a week, if not more. And I put up a video back in, I think, March or so, something around there. I'll link it for you guys down below on how to apply self tanner. It's really in depth, tells you all my tricks on getting like the perfect looking tan so it looks natural, and not too orange and all that kind of stuff. So this is the best self-tanner I've ever tried. If you're interested in this, I do have a discount code for you all. I will have that listed down below. It's just my username, GlammyUp8. You can use that to get a discount on your order. I think it's 10% off. And I also love Sun Goddess because they do give out free samples on their website. You just have to pay $1 for the shipping, and it's so you can try it out without having to spend the money on this because it is a little bit pricey. I think it's around $30 or so, but if you use my discount code, you will get a discount. But if you want to try it out before you actually buy the full bottle, I would recommend ordering the samples. You just pay $1 for shipping and you can try it out first, so that's awesome. So then for hair products, I have my Aussie Moist 3-Minute Miracle Deep Conditioner. I've talked about this so many times. I didn't show this in my last hair care routine because I was trying out a different deep conditioner, but I had to go back to this one. It's just my Holy Grail Deep Conditioner. It does have silicones in it, but I don't notice any buildup or anything on my scalp when I use this because I do use sulfate-free shampoo. But this just works really well. It's super cheap. It's like $3, and I just leave it on my hair about once a week in the shower and let it deep condition my hair because I think that's really important in the summer. My hair gets very dry from the sun and from the salt water and all that stuff. Then I've also been loving the L'Oreal Evercurl Sulfate Free Curl Care System Silk and Gloss Dual Oil Care. And this detangles and illuminates anti-frizz system. It has botanical oils in it. I've been using this whole Evercurl line. I use the shampoo and conditioner and the curl cream, but I wanted to try this out because I really like using serums on my hair, but sometimes they can be a little bit heavy, especially if you're using sulfate-free shampoo. They can be hard to remove. So I like how this is designed to work with that line, so it can be removed with the shampoo and use it with this. But it has just different oils and stuff. It's a spray oil, so you just shake it up and spray it all over your hair. I do this when my hair is wet, and then sometimes I'll also spray a little bit on throughout the day if my hair is still getting dry. But it helps fight the frizz. It keeps it really shiny and glossy, and then it also just keeps it from getting too dry and detangles as well. So love that stuff if you have curly hair, or even if you have just wavy hair, it works great for that too. So I guess first I will talk about my fashion favorite for the summertime, and then I will get into the swimsuits. So I love wearing bandeau tops underneath tank tops. So I like just wearing any type of tank top just like this. This one I just have a strapless bra on underneath, but if I'm wearing a different type of tank top that's more loose and stuff, then I like to wear a bandeau underneath. This one is from American Eagle, by the way. I got it on clearance, but it's just a bright yellow. They also had it in a mint green, so I just really love these really light, flowy tank tops and stuff because it's really hot where I live. But these bandeaus, I got these two at Wet Seal, and they were only like a dollar something, I think. They don't have any cups in them, which can be a little bit annoying, but I'll just wear like either a strapless bra underneath, or if I wear it with something that already has like a little bit of padding in it, then it works well. So this one is a white lace. It's very pretty. And then this one is a mint green color. This looks great underneath black or white or just any type of shirt. This one is a bright neon coral. This is from American Eagle. And this one has like a little bit of lace coming down underneath of it. And then I just have a couple of these regular ones. I think the pink one's from Charlotte Russe. The rest are from Wet Seal. This is a neon pink one, a black one, and a blue one. I have a white one as well, but that one is dirty. But these are just great. I wear them to work underneath my dresses and stuff. Well, I wear the black and the white one. But also, they're just really nice because they're very comfortable. So you can wear them underneath like a loose tank top. And you don't have to worry about bra strap showing because, especially with a tank top like this, I can't stand it when you've got like, you know, bra strap showing. It just looks bad, or your bra shows in the back or on the sides. So for the tank tops that hang really loose and stuff, those are perfect for that. And I'm pretty sure I have an old video on how to style bandeaus, so I did a whole video about them. If you're curious on how to style them, then definitely check that out below. And I think they're really great for younger girls too, because you don't have to wear like a full-on bra with them. Because those ones, the solid color ones that I have, those are actually have the cups in them, so they're really nice. You don't have to worry about wearing a bra with them. So then my other fashion favorite is the chambray or denim type shirts. This one actually came from Kohl's. It's by the brand Sew. And I think it was only around like $20 or so, so it wasn't too expensive. I got mine in large because I wanted it to fit more big and loose, but I also rolled up the sleeves. And then these are just great to throw them on over top of a maxi dress or a long skirt or even just a regular tank when it starts to get chilly at night. So that's what I really love these for. Or if I'm going out to eat, it's always freezing in restaurants. So this is much lighter weight than a denim jacket, so I just really like that because it's very still lightweight, but it gives you like a little bit of warmth. And they look super cute, like just with white shorts, lace shorts, whatever. And then I also like to tie up the bottom, and you can wear it over top of a swimsuit as a cover up. If you just tie up the ends, just looks really cute. And I like wearing them, especially over maxi dresses. So I want to do a styling video on maxi dresses for short people, because I'm only 5'2", and it's hard for me to find maxi dresses, but I've actually found a couple that work for me and are not too long. So if you want to see a video on how to style dresses when you're shorter, definitely we'll do that for you guys. And for my swimsuits, I guess I will start off with my favorite one. This one, or they're both actually from Victoria's Secret, and I always get them on sale there when they run them on sale, and then I also usually will find a coupon online. But these are in the color Seafoam Glow, and I just love the color of this. It's so bright and fun for summertime. I just love really bright bikinis, and then also ones that have fuller coverage, because I don't like showing a lot, so I don't like having stuff that just shows like a ton. So I really like these bottoms. They do have pretty good coverage in the back, so you don't have half your butt cheeks hanging out. And they're just really nice because they elongate your legs with having the side tie, but it still has like enough coverage and you can adjust it. I'm kind of leery about ordering bathing suits online that don't have the side tie adjustments. I feel like it's hard to get the bottoms that are just regular ones to fit just right. But here's the top that goes with it, or that I got with it. You can mix and match any of these, of course, at Victoria's Secret. But this one is the draped halter. I think they also have another one that has more push up to it that's the same. But this has a little bit of gold detailing right here, and it's again in that seafoam color. And it does have a tiny bit of padding in it, so you're not going to show too much. It does have that coverage on the inside, and then also has a little bit of padding on the end. But it's not too much to where it, like, you know, makes you look huge. And then I also got this one. I love this print. When I saw this on the website, I'm like, oh my goodness, I have to have that. Because I love bright floral prints. But this one is in the color white floral. And this is just the triangle halter, I think, or tie front triangle, I think it's called. I will link these swimsuits for you guys on my blog if you're interested in buying them. But this one, again, has a little bit of padding on the side, so it's not too much, but it does still have coverage. And then the top is the strings, and then it has a really cute purple bow here in the middle, and then it just ties in the back. So I love this bright floral print. And the bottoms I got to go with it are the same side tie bottoms. They're just in this print, and they've got the purple strings on them. So I just think these are really cute. I love the bright print. I could also wear these with the Seafoam Glow stuff because they match with that. They could also match with neon pink or that bright purple as well, or even yellow. So you can mix and match these with a lot of different things. But I just love Victoria's Secret bathing suits. They are a bit pricey, but if you can find coupons, I think they're really worth it because they will last you a long time. I still have bathing suits from them that I ordered probably 2 or 3 years ago, and they're still in great shape. So, but of course I don't wear them every day or anything, but I think they last a lot longer than regular ones, and they have really cute prints and stuff. But Target is also a good option if you guys want to get cheaper ones. Last year I actually got this one from Target, and it's like a bright neon pink with white stripes, and it has these little hearts here and a little ruffle. This one's just so cute. This is more of that bandeau style top. And then these neon pink bottoms that go with it are actually from Walmart. So if you just want regular bottoms, Walmart's a great place for that. And this is still in good shape. I got it towards the end of the summer, so I didn't wear it as much as my other ones. But it's still in pretty good shape, and it's a lot cheaper than the Victoria's Secret ones. So definitely check Target or TJ Maxx if you want cheaper swimsuits. But if you want really high quality ones, Victoria's Secret is the way to go, I think. So I believe that is everything for my summer favorites. Let me know what your favorite bathing suit is of the season, and leave it in the comments below, or your favorite place to buy them, because I would love to check out some new ones. And then also tell me your favorite makeup product that you like to use, or beauty product for the summertime. What's your number one beauty product for the summer? So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will have all the products that I mentioned listed on my blog, as well as the clothing items and the bathing suits and all, if you're interested in purchasing any of them. There will also be discount codes and all listed in the information box below. Don't forget to comment and subscribe if you haven't already, and check out my last video. I will talk to y'all very soon. Thank you so much for watching.